What's up, guys? It's Touch Protections Workshop. Today we're going to be in the shop, and I've built the box for this picket winder. I've just basically kind of done it to where I could test it out to see if this thing's going to work good or not. But this is what we've got here, kind of what I've come up with to where all the pulleys and everything mounted in there. And I'm going to go through the process of putting this thing together. The only thing I really want to do at the end of this video is I want to get a RPM reading on this our pulley and shaft there. So anyways, guys, hope you enjoyed the video. If you do, give me a like, and if you like it, please subscribe. Thanks for watching, guys. All right, guys, so what I've decided to do here is make the pickup winder box kind of similar to the old one, and I'm going to use this supply wood, and I'm thinking about using this for like the front piece, and then kind of cutting a rabbet in here to where I can these will sit inside here, not a rabbet, but a you know what I mean, to where these will slide down into it and hold it together. So that's what we're going to do here. Box dimensions are going to be 6 by 8. It's going to be the 8 is going to be the height, 6 is going to be the width. Alright, guys, so now what I'm going to do, I've pretty much got the box built. I've got the two pieces together, back to back, or front, outside to outside, so I'm going to drill a hole straight through here and get a center on all of this. Move it up just a little bit more. And then we're going to drill it out for the... I measured this in. I went in 2.5 inches from the outside, and I came down 2 inches. I just thought that might be a good area to start. And this might even be the final box. I'm just trying to get it to where I can test out the motor and stuff like that with the pulleys. So that's what we're going to do here. Now what I want to do is take this paddle bit. It's a 5/8 paddle bit, and it's probably going to be a little big for these bearings. But I'm hoping once I get them all in there, I can might can use like a shaft collar to hold everything together. That's my plan, anyways. Now, what I want to do is I want to set the depth about the thickness of my bearing here. So, there we go. So now we've got something to actually mount all that stuff to. That one right there, I'm gonna have to probably do something with that one. That one's a little loose. But basically gonna have that there. And then I'm gonna have the shaft go through there like so. And the most important part of building a pickup winder is having coffee. I just ran out. There we go. We've got our bearings in there. And I need to mount the pulley on there now. In here somewhere. Hoping you can see that good. I can't even see it at all. See there. So we're going to mount a pulley in there. Now, I need to figure out, I guess it needs to be as close to one side as I can get it. I ain't figured out which. This is going to be the front right here. So I'm going to mount it over here. Where's the motor? So our motor's going to be like right there. So it needs to be like right here, close to the front. Right there. All poorly. We're pretty good on the sides. Let's see, where's that going? That's going to be pretty. You see that? That's pretty close. Thing spins really nicely. I know it's crude, it looks horrible, but it's just for testing purposes. Now what I want to do is I want to get this thing, I want to cut these V-grooves and these pulleys here so we can put our bands on. Pretty good. What do y'all think about it? Let me know what you think. Like I said, this bracket was just to test this thing out, because I want to see how this thing does. But I want to get a RPM reading off of this here now to see where we're at on it. All right, so here's what we got, guys. We've got the bigot winder sitting here, and I've got everything hooked up, and I'm fixing to get an RPM reading off of this thing. I'm gonna cut this guy on here. I'm just going to let it run up and see what it does. So that's full throttle right there. I'm going to try to get an RPM reading off this thing. Right at 1,860 RPMs, and that's good. We were trying to be between 1,800 and 2,000, so we slowed our motor down from 3,420 to 1,860 by using the pulleys and stuff. So now I want to see how slow we can make this thing actually go. I'm going to try to go maybe halfway, right around in there somewhere. So that's about where our old pickup winder would wind at. It's about 1,200. It's right at 600. So we can get pretty slow with it. And the only thing that might be that I have to figure out too is, you know, once I get this thing done and actually start winding a pickup, with the weight of the pickup and everything else on it, we might have to adjust the size of the big pulley. Because when this thing's under a load, it might not spin to the full 1,800 RPM. So we might have to adjust some stuff around to get it to work right on that part. And, you know, when you got a pickup on there and it's spinning and you got a wire coming into it and it's actually
having to make the motor work is going to slow it down too. So we might have to adjust the pulley, make it a little bit smaller in order to get over, you know, say 2200 RPMs. But by the time we get the pickup and start using it, it's around that area that we want it to be. Well, all right, guys, that's it for this video. If you have any questions or comments, or especially any suggestions of anything that I could do to make this thing better or anything, just let me know, please. I'd really appreciate it. I appreciate all your questions and comments and suggestions and stuff that you guys give me. If you like the video, give me a like. And if you like it, please subscribe. Thanks for watching, guys.